This module about electrification of road transport will elaborate on the impact of electric vehicles on the after-sales market. Our focus so far has been on the changes electric vehicles will bring to the manufacturing of electric vehicles and charging infrastructure. This is rightly so, as this constitutes the majority of the turnover in the auto industry. However, other markets within the auto industry are also relevant. Combined, the after-sales market, financial services and connectivity markets are good for more than 35% of the total turnover. Moreover, these markets operate at a way higher profit margin than the car sales markets. While car sales markets operate at only a few percent profit margin, after sales and financial services have profit margins from 20 up to 60%. These markets are, however, not immune to the disruption of electric vehicles. In this lecture, we will focus on the after-sales market. Let us first start with a general description of the after-sales market. The market exists out of four levels: the parts manufacturer, the distributors, the workshops, and the customer level. The parts manufacturers can be separated into three different stakeholders: the original equipment manufacturers, those that also produce the vehicles; dedicated suppliers that supply original equipment; and those that are operating in the so-called gray market. Businesses operating in this gray market mainly make generic parts that can fit onto many different vehicles. The original equipment manufacturers and suppliers work with a distribution channel which mainly supplies to workshops that are linked to dealerships, but they can also supply to the independent workshops. The generic parts suppliers usually only deliver to independent garages, but do so often on a higher profit margin. The customer level can be separated into private and business customers, the last constituting out of fleet owners. Electric vehicles are going to disrupt the market in several ways. The main drivers behind this disruption are the following. First, the decreasing share of mechanical and moving parts, from more than 10,000 in an internal combustion engine to somewhere between 30 to 150 in an electric vehicle. Second, longer service intervals. Due to the lower need of repair, customers will visit the workshop less often. Third, developments in battery technology. This new technology will need to be learned by maintenance personnel, requiring additional investments in knowledge and equipment. Fourth, less additional units can be supplied. Many car enthusiasts like to tune their car, for which they bought additional components. Electric vehicles allow for fewer modifications to the car. The last major disruption is that customers are less able to repair the cars themselves. This forces the driver to go to the repair shop when the car breaks down. So how do these developments affect the market for maintenance and repair? We should note that already the market for maintenance and repair has been in decline for years. This is mainly due to the increasing quality that automakers deliver. Electric vehicles will make suppliers to focus on different parts. They have to switch from mechanical to electrical parts. The shift to electrical means that the regular maintenance, such as oil change, changing of spark plugs, and the replacement of timing belt, will no longer be necessary. This can entirely disrupt the supply chain of the spare parts, forcing current companies out of the market. As the spare parts are more specialized, this also leaves less room for the gray market and for independent repair shops. Personnel at the workshops should be re-educated to switch from mechanical engineers to become electrical engineers. This requires substantial efforts and investment from these repair shops. Moreover, engineering education should already today focus on electrical engineering, as the information acquired by students today can already be obsolete in 10 to 20 years' time. Repair shops should also train personnel to safely handle electric vehicles. These systems work under high voltage, and therefore safety is of the utmost importance. Engineers should be trained how to safely disconnect the system and how to determine that indeed the voltage is low. The same holds for on-the-road repair engineers and for emergency personnel in the case of a crash. Governments should help by translating the current safety standards in the electrical engineering industry to be adjusted for current practices in the automobile repair. Besides training the staff, auto repair shops should also invest in additional equipment, such as metering, insulation materials, protective equipment, and safe storage of this equipment. In general, it is expected that electric vehicles require fewer visits to the repair shops, the number of spare parts to be reduced, but the number of hours of work because of increased difficulty will remain stable. This increased difficulty will also mean that customers are getting forced to repair their car at the dealership, leaving less room for the gray market and independent workshops. So far, our attention has been on the service of the moving parts of the vehicle. The new and more vulnerable part of the electric vehicle is, however, the battery. There have been many questions about the battery lifespan and how it compares to the average lifespan of a vehicle. In early electric vehicles, the battery has been the most difficult part to maintain. However, auto and battery makers are learning at a very fast pace. Current batteries can easily last 200,000 kilometers while only degrading 5% in capacity. At less than 85% capacity, the vehicle battery is seen as written off, but it is still useful for other less capacity critical applications, such as battery storage. The key feature is the battery management system. To ensure a decent lifespan of the battery, many automakers provide a warranty of a period from up to 5 up to 10 years. In case the battery breaks down, it will be replaced for free by the manufacturer. Due to the rapid advancements in battery technology, new vehicles on the road have longer ranges. Such developments are likely to continue in the coming years. Some of the automakers can offer battery upgrades for relatively low prices. This can provide additional work for the repair shops in the coming years. Besides the developments on the spare parts and batteries under another significant change, it's disrupting the after-sales market. Due to the electrification, the control of many parts of the vehicle is no longer done through mechanical feedback, but through software. The vehicles have become more computers on wheels. This also allows the vehicles to become connected to the outside world. Besides updates on more obvious functions such as the navigation, the electrification also means that the performance of the car can be improved via over-the-air updates, just like your mobile phone. This allows car manufacturers, within the limits of the hardware present, to improve the car during its lifetime. It can also reduce the number of recalls automakers have to make, as some of the fixes can be made through the internet connection the car has. Such connections are, however, not free, and this makes connectivity one of the fast-growing segments within the auto markets. Moreover, connectivity opens the door for more vehicle sharing and is the basis for mobility as a transport or transport as a service. New business models that over time replaces the ownership-based models and after-sales model. A positive, disruptive win-win business which creates added value for the service provider and cost reduction for the mobility user. To wrap up, we have seen that the electrification of transport not only will disrupt the manufacturing industry, but the change will be more detrimental for the after-sales market. The reduced number of moving parts and the higher complexity will mean less work for repair shops, require additional investment in knowledge and equipment, and will mean a shift from independent repair to dealerships. Battery warranty will ensure a decent lifespan, and possible upgrades of the battery can result in additional work for the after-sales market. And last but not least, connectivity, which supports over-the-air updates for cars, can reduce functional errors and improve new business opportunities like mobility as a service, the future of smart e-mobility. Thank you for watching this video.